My name is Javier. I'm a professional chess coach. Be sure to check me out at chess.clinic. Thank you.
G'day. How's it going? I'm doing very well, and I hope you are too. Today we're doing something a little different in this video. We're going to be taking a look at Chessbase 15, but just one of its new hidden features, which very few people know about. In fact, this is such a hidden feature that I'm pretty sure that some people at Chessbase headquarters don't even know that it exists. So let's take a look at it. As you probably know, we can use arrows and highlight squares in Chessbase using three colors. Green, we can use yellow, and we can use, okay, sorry about that, arrow. Red color, I meant to draw this arrow instead. So those are the three basic colors, and I'm pretty sure the people at Chessbase, in their wisdom, decided that they only wanted to use three colors. Because if they did use more than three colors, you know, a chessboard could end up looking like something that has little to do with the chessboard. So I think it was a wise decision by them. But having said that, blue is a nice color, and some people like blue. So why not have blue arrows instead of these traffic lights limited colors? Here we go. Look at that. That's blue. How do you draw that arrow? Well, and how do you draw that highlighted square in blue? Well, I'm going to tell you all about these in a moment. But before I do that, I wanted to tell you about a new channel on YouTube that a friend of mine has created. And it's a very interesting channel. It's called Mike Chess. The interesting thing about this channel is the quality of the content. Mike Cotto is a FIDE master. He's a strong FIDE master. And as I said, what I like about this channel is that you don't get crappy videos about things that have little to do with chess. You get real lectures on topics that advanced players or players who are starting out want to learn about. The content of this channel, as I said, is quality content. Like me, Mike is struggling to get 1,000 subscribers, so give it a chance, check it out, and you know, if you like it, make sure you subscribe. It's a good channel. So back to Chessbase 15. How did I draw that blue arrow using the hidden features of Chessbase 15? Well, before I continue, let me say that this feature is not only limited to Chessbase 15. You can use it in any version of Chessbase. And why did I say that it was a hidden feature in Chessbase 15? Well, it's not exactly a lie, because you know, I'm using Chessbase 15, and here's the blue color. You haven't seen it before. No one's seen it before. But it actually works in any version of Chessbase. So it was a little bit of clickbait, and you know, I'm struggling. I've only got 300 subscribers, you know, and my best video on my channel, which is probably the video on counterpins, it only got like 500 views. It's a high quality video, very interesting topic, which no one has mentioned before in any books, or there's very little, you know, people have never done videos on that topic, and it only got 500 lousy views, you know. And then I did that video on Carlsen's blunders, and it got over 20,000, and people just insulted me in the comments and stuff. I mean, give me a break. I mean, you know, I have to use clickbait. I've got to get my first 1,000 subscribers. Give me a chance. Okay, but having said that, how did I do it? Well, there's some good news and some bad news. The bad news is that you cannot do it from Chessbase. I know it sounds kind of shocking, because this is Chessbase, and I'm seeing the blue arrow and the blue square there. How come I can't do it from Chessbase? Well, this has to do with what I mentioned earlier on. In their wisdom, the people at Chessbase decided that they only wanted to have traffic lights colors, And but the workaround, there are two workarounds. The good news is that there are two workarounds. The first one is simply using leeches. Okay, so the first step is I'm gonna visit leeches and the leeches chess site, and then I'm gonna go to learn study. I'm gonna go to my public studies, and then I'm gonna create a new one, and I'm gonna call it whatever. And I'm gonna make it invite only. And then I'm just gonna make some moves. Actually, this move instead. Takes knight here, h3, double question mark. Then takes, and after g3, white's gonna get checkmated. So instead of using yellow here, I'm gonna be using blue. And the way I do it is a keyboard combination. I'm actually pressing Control plus Alt. Control Alt makes the blue color, and you can use arrows and as you know, you can use any other color. You can use this one, you can use red, and you can use green, and so on. So blue color. White's getting checkmated. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this icon, share and export, and I'm going to download the chapter. So I'm going to click here. And as you can see, it's already downloaded. It's in my computer now, and if I double click on that, it'll open the file, or you can open it from Chessbase if you prefer it that way. And you'll see the blue color. That's not the only way, though. There is a second way, which is a little bit more complicated, but we're going to be learning about it now. This is what a Chessbase file, a PGN file, I should say, PGN file looks like in a text editor. You need a text editor, like the Node program that comes with Windows. I think that's what it's called. And you have to edit that file. Now, the interesting thing is this code that we see here. Now, e4 is the move that was played in the game. Now, look at this code in brackets, CSL, which stands for color squares, and then we get GE2, BB5, RC3, YF3, and those letters in capitals represent the colors. So G is for green, B is for blue, R is for red, and Y is for yellow. So green e2 square, bishop, no, sorry, blue b5 square, and red c3 square, and yellow f3 square. And then we close brackets, and then the new brackets, and then we get different code, percentage CAL, which stands for arrows. And then we get green, G for green, and then E2, E4. That's the arrow that goes from E2 to E4, the one that goes from F1 to B5, the one that goes the red color arrow that goes from B1 to C3, and so on and so on. And that's all there is to it. There's not much more. But here's a little twist. Let's go back to Chessbase. And now I'm going to open a new file. And now take a look at this file. This time we have even more colors. We have the g6 square in orange. There's this arrow that goes from h5 to h6, which looks like orange. It could be brown. I think it's orange. Yeah, I think it's orange. And then we've got the h2 to h4 arrow, which is a cyan color. That's what it stands for, C for cyan. And it does look like cyan in Chessbase 10, but when I actually open this file in Chessbase 15, it looks like purple for some reason. I don't really know why. I don't really understand why. And now if we look at the code, there's here somewhere. Like I experimented with many other initials just to see if I could see other colors. But as I said, let's see the what was it? H5 to H6, I think it was. So I'm going to find h5, h6. Okay, here it is, and I use O for orange. So yeah, I'm pretty sure that was orange. And yeah, that's how it's done. It's not particularly complicated. It does take a little bit of getting used to. It is a little bit of a pain. I mean, why would you want to use those colors in Chessbase in your game annotations? This, apart from, you know, showing off to some people, but other than that, you know, you really don't want too many colors on a chessboard. Three is probably enough. Blue, maybe we should give blue a chance. What do you think? Let me know. Maybe we should take a poll on this. I don't know. I mean, you know, I think three colors is enough.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.